Manchester. In London tonight, the East End pays its last respects to Ronnie Cray. We talked to him, Reggie.
But the victims of Cray violence say we'll never forgive nor forget.
Also tonight, why Stephen Fry is being sued for £500,000 over a trip to France.
Tonight's news is dominated by the funeral of Ronnie Cray. The scenes in the East End today have been quite astonishing. Vast crowds lining the streets. Police who once hunted the men halting all traffic to allow the huge funeral procession to pass.
All this for a convicted gangland killer. Ronnie's twin brother Reggie, allowed out of prison for only the third time in 27 years, was himself greeted like a returning hero. Inside the church, he had this to say to London Tonight.
Well, there were their friends and supporters and there were nice people. So I'm very pleased to see them today, but I wish it had been under good circumstances, but still nice to have this again.
Well, it's been a day of mixed emotions. Expressions of affection for the Cray twins, mingling with memories of the terror they brought to the East End of the 60s. Phil Bales was able to witness all of today's events at close hand.
An old man in a dark suit, handcuffed to a prison officer, let out of jail for only the third time in 27 years. It's Ronnie Cray's funeral, but it's Reggie Cray who's calling the shots. Even from behind bars, he wrote the plot for this old-fashioned East End funeral. A Victorian glass hearse, awash with flowers drawn by six black-plumed horses. Reggie's wreath for the other half of me. And an honour guard of heavies to watch the coffin overnight and walk alongside the hearse. Reggie Cray's prison car was mobbed as the cortege set off along Bethnal Green Road. It may have been affection, maybe even fear, which brought some of these people out onto... In many cases, it was just plain curiosity. Yet even though the Crays carved up the East End in a reign of terror, it was hard to find anyone prepared to condemn them.
You were safer during in them days with them about than what you are now. They beat my old ass. And they beat Roldies, they with an old fist.
Those armies. Only you travel amongst your own, that was all.
Once again, Ronnie and Reggie Cray were attracting the attentions of the police. But this time, their job was to make sure Reggie Cray's plans went smoothly. Looking down on Valence Road, where both villains were born, where their mother, Violet, taught them to box, her house is long gone, but a brief stopover was made in her memory. And then to St. Matthew's Church in Bethnal Green for the funeral service. Hear more cheers for Cray as he leads the mourners, but a lone voice can be heard shouting murderer. A mob leader mobbed as people stop him, trying to shake his hand. The convicted killer even gets a kiss. Much too young for 50s and 60s gang violence and extortion to mean anything to them, but an almost godfatherly greeting from the first handcuffed prisoner they'll have seen away from television. Indeed, embraces in the style of Godfather dominated reunions between men too old and tough for kissing. In a quiet moment, Reggie Cray spoke to London Tonight about his brother and the occasion.
There were their friends and supporters and there were nice people. So I'm very pleased to see them today. But I wish it had been under good circumstances, but still nice to have their support. He's a good brother, he's very loyal, and he's very generous. And he has lots of nice ways about him. And I should always remember good memories of that. And I know he's at peace. That's the main thing. And he's at peace.
My Way, Ronnie Cray's favourite song. He had no regrets about his violent past and no illusions about the consequences. Acceptance too from Reggie Cray and a message read out on his behalf that his brother had a bad side to his character.
Long had great humour, a vicious temper, was kind and generous. He did it all his way.
Charlie Cray, eldest of the three, said out of violence could come peace. The pallbearers represented past gangland factions coming together from all parts of London.
They were all the guys who were today coming north, south, east and west, but they're all respected. And so it stops all these young people thinking their thing. Live in peace, I think, that's the best thing.
Reggie Gray has said when his twin died, a part of him died too. This was his choice as his brother's anthem. Travelling at the speed of six trotting horses.
Chingford, the final stage of the journey, and this vast crowd has grown even larger. Many are here just for the spectacle. After all, you don't see a funeral like this every day. But most, I suspect, are here for a glimpse, however, of Reggie Cray.
Reggie Cray was last here with his twin brother for their mother's funeral in 1983. Today, Ronnie Cray was taken to the family plot to be buried alongside her. Before his final farewell to his brother, Cray was allowed a moment at their mother's grave. The Crays did not want this to be a private affair, even as active gangsters, they loved the limelight. Today, putting on a show is still the name of the game. Ronnie Cray, psychopath and killer, may have been deluded into thinking himself a king in the East End, and it was in that style he was laid to rest. In Chingford, this is Phil Bales for London Tonight.
Well, some of you may condemn those scenes, others applaud them, but the vicar of St. Matthew's Church, Father Christopher Bedford, defended the funeral. I feel that everybody has to be given a Christian burial and commended to God's mercy.
It was all too easy just for today to forget the Cray twins' murderous past, but there are some who can never forget. Raina Cornell was just 9 months old when her father was murdered. Christopher Peacock looks at the brutal legacy left by the Crays.
Well, he's a good guy, very good.
Watching Reggie Cray's interview on television, the daughter of George Cornell says she will dance on twin brother Ronnie Cray's grave now that he's dead and buried. Cornell, a rival gangster, was shot dead in Whitechapel's Blind Beggar Pub by Cray in 1967. Raina Cornell, just a baby when she lost her father, has neither forgiven or forgotten.
I'm either the moon big dead. The day I found out, I was driving along, and I think people in other cars must have been thought I was a raving lunatic because I was really, really jumping and arms in the air and everything.
The Crays were brought up by Mother Violet in Bethnal Green, but the spiff-suited twins turned to violence, carving up the East End, maiming and murdering.
All right, fair enough, people say. It was like their own, but they were still people, their families.
Cray died from a heart attack after serving 27 years in Broadmoor Hospital for the criminally insane. Not long enough, says Lenny Hamilton, who shed no tears at today's funeral. He fell foul of the Cray firm in the 60s, being tortured and blinded by Ronnie Cray with a red-hot poker.
He turned around again, because he had to get another poker off, because this one was a bit colder now, we've got another white-hot one, and I shut the eyes. And he put it to the eyes, I could feel the heat burning me across there. The eyes, and he told me to open the eyes. So as I opened the eyes, the heat penetrated me left eye, that's what blinded me left eye.
Reggie Cray mobbed this afternoon by well-wishers outside the church after his funeral. The crowd, several hundred strong, caught up in the so-called hero worship that masks the truth. A peculiar folklore has grown up around the Crays by a generation fed on a diet of books and films that have glamorized their iron fist hold on the East End.
The whole point of the film, particularly Ronnie, was that people were scared stiff of them. This is their stock in trade. Ronnie, particularly, was a very frightening man. He was a great fighter. He killed people and he cut people up and he went for people. He wasn't a sweet old sugar daddy. And this is what the essence of their power was. People were terrified of them.
Big men in suits, the heavy mob, keeping a high profile at today's funeral.
there to guard Craig's coffin. For them admitting, we're worried. There are a lot of people out there who don't like the Craigs.
Oh, they're not bad. But what about if they'd have done it to their families? What would they be saying now? Well, these people that spout the Craigs are not bad. They only did it to their own. If they never did it to their own, they wouldn't be in prison today. And they'd have had a lot of friends.
Journey's End at Chingford Cemetery. Ronnie Craig's dead. An old-style funeral for an old-fashioned gangster. But it's unlikely the Craig myth will die with him.
I said that I'd like to dance on his grave and let his body come keep in the back of my mind. But I don't know. I'll have to wait and see.
And what of Reggie Craig? Will he die in prison too, like his twin brother?
He's immaterial to me. He really doesn't bother me in the slightest. He was just a small man behind his psycho brother, in my opinion.
Beyond the grave, nothing is certain. Will Ronnie Craig rest in peace? This is Christopher Peacock for London Tonight.
The end of an astonishing day in the East End of London. Well, tonight, Reggie Craig is back in Maidstone Prison. His victims hope he stays there. His supporters, of course, continue to plead for his release. And whatever happens, the truth of the matter is that the fascination with the Craigs goes on. Now, when we come back this evening, the rest of the day's news,
including the hospital consultant accused of staying in bed.
On the early evening news, 26 years in jail, Ronnie Craig dies of a heart attack. The biggest single cause of